Dead or Alive.
For some reason, punk rockers accepted that disco for its purity, and there was a slight rebellious spirit to it. Then, towards the end of punk rock, I thought, well, I don't want to be making punk rock records or psychedelic records. I want to make popular disco music. And that it wasn't a hard thought out concept. It was just I realized that I did have a talent and I did have an audience. So in order to please myself, I would do what I wanted to do, and pop and disco came into my life.
あまりにも強烈な個性を持つボーカルビート・バーンズとプロデューサースティーブ・コイを中心とした伝説のユニット Dead or Alive。 80年代のディスコシーンを席巻した彼らが久々のフルアルバム Fragile をリリース。
Give a new generation of people who were too young in the 80s who are now in their 20s a chance to hear what Dead or Alive did in the 80s butbring it up and make it a fresh sound for the year 2000, and it also shows the musical direction that we continue to evolve and grow into.
メガヒット曲のセルフカバーと新曲で構成されたニューアルバムの一部をスペシャルレコメンド。 You spin me round like a record 2000 remix version。 Watch out, here I come。Count to 10. 2000 remix version.
Turn around and count to 10. Before you lose the only one who really loves you. Somebody who likes you just as you are. Not how you might have been. When you turn around again, I might be with someone else who really loves me. And now I'll say what I don't want to say.
Something in my house, 2000 remix version.
There is something in my house, it's just a ghost of the blinded affair. There is something in my house, I just keep a hearing you running out of my fear. But you're not there.
Original new single, Hit and Run Lover.
I didn't get inspired by a certain person because there have been many times in my life when I was without any inspiration or anybody to look up to. I've never really had an idol or an icon visually. I'm not very impressed when I see supermodels dressed up by somebody else. If they've not done it themselves, it's all done for them. Everything that we and I do personally is done for myself and purely to please myself. And if it pleases other people visually and sound-wise, it's a bonus. But first and foremost, I like to please myself.
Why am I surprised you're a hit-and-run lover? Put the hammer to the wheel, baby, run for cover. Gonna tell it to your friends, you're a two-time mother. Tell me, why am I surprised you're a hit-and-run lover? Why am I surprised you're a hit-and-run lover? Put the hammer to the wheel, baby, run for cover. Gonna tell it to your friends, you're a two-time mother. Tell me, why am I surprised? Why am I surprised?
ユーロビットサウンドにも多大な影響を与えた Dead or Alive。 鮮やかに進化を遂げた彼らが2000年のダンスシーンに新たな旋風を巻き起こす。
Dead or Alive。 往年のファンはもちろん、新しい世代のリスナーからも支持を集めている彼らのサウンド。新生 Dead or Alive の活動から今後も目が離せませんね。
Well, that's all for this week's ABIX World Music News Report. Thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you soon. Back here on Channel A. Shibuya Kesha. Have a great day. Bye.
Hi, I'm Pete Burns from Dead or Alive. Hello, Japan. We're very, very happy to be back here.
Hi, I'm Steve Coy from Dead or Alive. You're watching Channel A.
Channel A.
1980年に結成。その奇抜なビジュアルと得意なサウンドで一大センセーションを巻き起こした伝説のグループ Dead or Alive。 91年のシングルリリースを最後に活動を停止。しかしそんな彼らがついに復活、ニューアルバムを発表。
It was just a real challenge. It was like running a marathon that you, and the only relief came at the completion of it and seeing the finished product and seeing it in its sleeve. It's a very rewarding feeling.
スペシャルインタビューですが、今回はかなりスペシャルですね。まあ、若い世代の子たちは Dead or Alive と聞いてもなかなかピンとこないかもしれませんが、僕らの世代から上、まあ、30歳から上の、まあ、中堅層の方々はですね、 Dead or Alive 青春だったよ、ディスコサウンドのですね、もう最たるところを言っていた方々なんですけども、彼らが復活して日本にやってきてくれました。実に10年ぶりでございましてですね、僕も喜び勇んで某ホテルのスイートルームに行きました。1時間半待たされましたね準備ができてないから待っててくれ、コーヒー飲んで待ってましたけどね、いざ会ってみたら近くで会うと怖かったですね蛇のような方ですね。でもね、喋ってみたら非常に真面目な方で、一つ質問をするとですね、10分ぐらい喋るんですよ。答えがそんなに多いかみたいな、それほど真剣にこちらの質問に答えてくれる、これが嬉しいですね。はい、天下のデッドアライブです。ぜひみんなも触れてみてください。インタビューです。
さあ、もう超スーパースペシャルゲストを今日はお呼びいたしました。 Dead or Alive からピート・バーンズ、そしてスティーブ・コイです。 Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
皆さんは、懐かしいなと思うか、それとも新しいなと思うか、初めてだなと思うか、複雑な日本のファンたちの今表情が伺えるかと思うんですけども、まず聞きたいのは、日本は何年ぶりですか？
9年。
もその間、まさか日本を忘れたとは言わせませんけど、日本のファンはすごく寂しい思いをしたと思うんですけども、この9年間何をなさっていたんですか、本国の方で。
Well, we never forgot, but I think that any kind of success that an artist has, it's a little like a flower, it blooms, and when it gets to its most beautiful, it dies. It was a naturalthing for us to disappear for a while. We wished it had carried on, but I suppose our relationship with the record company had worn out a little bit. We maybe wanted to change direction musically and be a little bit more experimental. I think every artist has to have a period of experimentation, and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. And I think the last album we did with the last label we were withthe album didn't do so well, the staff changed, we had a couple of bad experiencesWhile we were here, and it left, I suppose, a bad reputation, and we'd rather that was forgotten about. We then decided to go back to doing basic live work around America, and we had quite a bit of success in Australia and the US as well. But we never did forget about Japan. I'm extremely, extremely happy to be back in Japan. It's my favorite place to work because you all work very, very hard. Western people.I would say naturally very, very lazy, and the biggest culture shock for me here is everything runs exactly on time, and it's taken me a couple of days to get into everything running on time.
なるほどね。まだ日本に到着したばっかりだと思うんだけど、この9年間で、まあ、前回僕来た時にはテレビで見てたんですよね。で、9年経ちまして今年日本にやってきて、まず何か変わったこととか、日本がこうなってるな、印象どう今持ってますか？
Well, we haven't seen anything of it but the hotel room and a photo studio. I'm sure there are changes, and I'm sure that most of the changes will be for the better. But I don't like it. It's not my position to make a judgment on how a country is. It's not my position to judge that. Whatever has happened naturally.I would love to spend more time here and see particularly the youth culture. Occasionally in a in a car on the way to a photo shoot, you see really interesting young kids on the streets and stuff, the way they're dressed and the imagery, because they take it to an art form, and that really, really fascinates me. I'm really interested in seeing the street and youth culture of Japan, and I hope that at some point while I'm here on this trip that I will get some time to do that, because I find it very inspirational. It convinces me that imagery and appearance can be fun. It's not taken as politically or seriously as it is in the West. It's much more fun and harmless. There's no real political connotations.
1980年代後半、日本はですね、いわゆるディスコ、それからユーロビートの大ブームと言われていたんですけども、まあ、必ずディスコに行くとその夜一番の盛り上がりを見せたのが You Spin Me とかですね、Something in My House とか、ああいう曲がかかると一番の盛り上がりを見せたのは僕すごく覚えてるんですけども、今の日本のティーンエイジャーたちはパラパラという踊りがものすごいブームを見せてるんですけども、パラパラって知ってるかな？
What is it? I don't know what it is.
パワパワ知らないでしょうね。
To me, if I interrupt, that sounds like a new name for disco. It sounds like a new name because you always have to, it's like a product brand name. People have to call it something else. It's the same thing with new technology and a different name. You know, it's just a, it also, oh, I can't think of anything to say on that. I haven't been to a club yet. In fact, you know, personally speaking, I haven't been to a nightclub to just be, other than to perform in a nightclub. I haven't been to a nightclub now for about 8 years in England, Europe or America. I haven't done it at all because there was a lot of, there was a period in Europe and the US where I found listening to the music that was being played, I no longer felt there was a place for me in that music because there were no singers, it was samples, it was a house beat and an out of tune bass, and I'm sorry to criticise it, but I do feel particularly in England that the drug culture of ecstasy ruined music. It completely took the music away because people just wanted to twitch the bodies to try and course this drug through the veins to this beat. And Steve and I would sometimes go to clubs and, you know, try to go to clubs to think, well, maybe we can find some inspiration in it. And we looked very, very hard and we could find absolutely no inspiration in it at all. I just wanted to keep doing what I'm doing, and I'm very lucky that everything in the creative fields, it's like a big circle, it comes round and round and round again, and if you just stay doing what you started to do, eventually a new generation pick up on it and it's new to them. I had no desire to go and reinvent ourselves musically and change ourselves into an acid house the band or anything. I wanted to do disco. I grew up wanting to do disco, and I think that I'll die doing disco. But I can do other things. You never get to hear them. I have the ability to do other things. I can do great ballads, I can do jazz, I can do a lot of things. But what I feel most comfortable doing as a performer and an image is disco music.
なるほど。一応説明して、このパラパラというのはですね、新しいこう日本のティーンエイジャー独特のダンシングパターンなんですよね。パラパラというのはですね、ちょっと教えてあげてください。
I haven't seen it, so.
ぜひ日本にいる間に一回。
I mean, I just think the fact that it free, whatever the beat or the rhythm does, if it frees the body and they move, it's more positive than them lying on the floor drunk, not, unable to move. I think it's a positive thing, dance music. There was a bleak period in the UK, as I said, where it was just, when you described to me a dancing style, there was a bleak period in the UK that I saw where people were kind of moving about like they were having epileptic fits because they had so much drugs going through the body, they couldn't sit still. That to me is why, when you say that word, that's what I think of these people trance dancing. I'd like to think that the music that we do inspires a feeling of happiness in people as opposed to a feeling of anesthesia, you know, whether they feel dead. I just want to make positive music, really.
今もそういう、いわゆるデッドアライブとしての、またピートとしての こうポリシーというものが音楽に対するポリシーというものがすごく伺えたんですけども、例えば、ちょっとスティーブにも聞いてみようかな。スティーブなんかは、楽曲を作っていくときに、どのようなことを意識してどういうポリシーを持って、音楽を作っていくんですか、スティーブ。
Policy when we create music is to make a great pop song. That's the main thing. A great pop song, a great chorus that people could sing, that people will remember.And trying to make every track as different as possible. Most people's albums are really boring. One, two, maybe three tracks might be good. The rest of the tracks on the album are album fillers. We try to make every single track on the album a really good record. And that is the most important thing. Not making something that sounds exactly the same. Every single track sounds the same. I like to give some variation.I like to give people a different taste and a different flavor and combine different flavors and different styles of music. That's the main thing.
なるほどね。まあテレビの前の皆さんには少し言っておきたいんですけども、1980年代のですね、半ば頃から90年代の初頭にかけて、日本のディスコ第1次か第2次ぐらいのですね、ディスコブームの時ですね、このデッドアライブの曲がもうバンバンディスコかかってました。で、1988年から89年にかけてですね、ヌードというですね、アルバムが出たんです。これが日本でチャートナンバーワンを獲得して、東京ドームがまだできたばっかりの時にですね、東京ドームで4万人から5万人を集めた、大ディスコイベント、デッドアライブのディスコイベントがあったんです。まさにこう日本中そして世界中をですね、もう席巻してしまったデッドアライブの時代がありました。そして寂しいけども9年間の時代を経てどうしちゃったのかなと思ってやっと帰ってきてくれて、今のスティーブの話にあったように、決して同じような音楽を作りたくない。例えばアルバムを作るんだったら全てが楽しめるような違う音楽を作りたい。で、信じられないほど嬉しいんですけども、9月の27日にですね、フラジャイルというですねアルバム出してくれました。これ13曲入ってるんですが、これ聞いたらほとんどが、まあもちろん新曲も入ってますが、ほとんどが懐かしい歌の数々のセルフカバー、ヒット曲のセルフカバーなんですけども、これ何か意図があるんでしょうか。
Well, it was a mutual decision between us and the new record company, Avex. It was because you have to remind people of your past history. You can't come in with no history now. It's very difficult. So we had to do self-covers to remind people of what they heard before and try and bring something new to them. I have to say, although it was fun to do the self-covers, it was actually very, very difficult to do them. It was, at times it was a very miserable experience because I was always ready to move on and do something else. And to go back and reassess things that you've done all those years ago, sometimes they were really very good and we couldn't make them better than they were. I don't say that in an arrogant way. It was very difficult to self-cover them, make them different but as good, and we didn't really have the kind of time to really, really think about it because I was writing new songs as we were recording the old ones. So there was so many things going on at once that at times we thought we were going to have complete nervous breakdowns. We really, really did to try and do old things and think, right, this new song, we don't want to make it sound like what we've just done. Had we done an album of completely new songs, it would have been easier for us artistically to do.But nonetheless, it turned out to be a good learning experience that you can never just leave everything behind and start anew. You do have to remind people. And I also think a lot of the younger generation possibly aren't that familiar with these songs. So they're new to them, they're new to an audience.
その通りだと思います。まあ、15年前に聴いていた人間たちというのは今もう35歳ぐらいまでなっている方々多いと思います。そして新しく今のティーンエイジャー、日本のティーンエイジャーたちはもしかしたらデッドアライブ初耳かもしれませんよね。この9月27日のですねフラジャイルを聞いて、ああ懐かしいなっていうのと、ああ新しいなっていうのとですね、両方が交錯するかもしれません。この状況がすごく楽しみ。そして日本のこれからのディスコではどんどんまたこのデッドアライブのこのアルバムがかかりまくるでしょう。そしてパラパラという踊りか、または新しい新種のダンススタイルで踊ってくれる方が多くなるんじゃないでしょうかと思いますが、まあ あなた方が来るのをずっと待っていた日本のファンたち、そして新しい日本のティーンエイジャーのファンたちにですね、何かメッセージを送っていただきたいと思うんですけども。
Well, you know, we're just very, very glad to be back. I hope it works out. I hope that they like it. If they don't like it, we did the best that we possibly could. But the success in this country and the response of the public means, and also the way the industry functions in this country means more to us than any other country in the world that we've worked in. If I had the option to choose where I would work and be successful, I would gladly forget about every other country in the world and concentrate here.Because we're a different culture, there are cultural differences, and it takes me a while to get used to the way you work and things like that, but ultimately I find it a much healthier and more rewarding process. And I would, you know, like to say to the fans, the old and the new, that I hope they like it, and if they don't, well, excuse me, there's nothing I can do about it. We did our best. But it could have been better. We did our best, but I think every artist thinks that when they finish an album, oh, we could have done better.Somebody has to say, right, stop, or it could go on forever.
You know, we made some great, great pop songs in the 80s, and there's some great new pop songs on this new album. So, you know, it's the taste of the old and the taste of the new together, and some of the old tracks and some of the new tracks, but everything with a new flavor and a new taste. So it's all fresh for today.
There are, in music as well, particularly in music, there are,what we call in the Western world trailblazers, people who do things that set a standard, and I feel that Dead or Alive was phenomenally influential on a lot of other artists and producers during the 80s, but we were so influential that we never got the credit. For instance, without a Debbie Harry and a Blondie, we would never have a Madonna. Without a Debbie Harry and a Blondie, we would never have a Courtney Love. And people tend to notPeople try and not mention their influences, and I hear our influences in many other people's records. I hear, for instance, what's her name? Kylie Minogue's record, I'm Spinning Around. You know, it's obvious that whoever wrote that song and sung it for her has been influenced by us because it was a good title. I hear our influences in a lot of people, bands like Erasure that probably went on to have more success than us.Bands like Bananarama, they were very influenced by us, but nobody mentions us because artists are very, very petty and paranoid. I have to fight very hard not to become like one of them. They don't like to mention where they've taken their ideas from. In fact, most of them don't have any ideas. They're told what to do.
Ah, なるほどね。もう本当にもう Thank you very much. もう本当素晴らしいメッセージを皆さんありがとうございました。初めて今日お会いしてね、もしかしたらちゃんと答えてくれるかなってすごく心配したんだけど、2人とも本当に真剣に受け答えしてくれて、僕はもう今日感動しています。ありがとう。本当にどうもありがとう。
どうも、
ぜひこれから日本でも頑張ってください。
how you doing? I hope really, really good because today I'm at Tokyo Big Sight. ついに私は東京ビッグサイトにやってきました。イエーイ！今日はこの夏最大のダンスイベント AVEX RAVE 2001の会場からお届けします。 You better check this out, it's gonna be good.
2001年8月17日、この日後世にまで語り継がれること必須のスペシャルダンスパーティーが東京ビッグサイトで行われた。新たな伝説が誕生する瞬間をその目に直に焼き付けるべく、日本全国から多くのダンスフリークが集結した。彼らの熱い一日が今始まる。 AVEX RAVE 2001夏の1ページを鮮やかに彩った21世紀最大級のダンスパーティー。今回はユーロビート、ハイパーテクノ、トランスという3つのジャンルが融合。巨大イベントスペースの各ホールが空前絶後のダンスフロアへと変貌したのである。総入場者数32,000人。未だかつてないスケールで開催された今回のイベント、ファーストステージのスタートを待ちわびていたオーディエンスたちが会場と同時に一斉にホールへと向かう。フロアに足を踏み入れた者全てが主人公となり得た壮大なる物語 AVEX RAVE 2001、その全貌を完全リポート。そしてステージにはあのデッドアライブが登場。ついに実現した彼らの来日ライブとともにパーティーはクライマックスを迎えたのである。 Why am I surprised? Why am I surprised? I'm mad